Hi everyone, welcome back to another of our premier challenges held here straight at Dueller's Point, the Mirage Island's favorite underground bunker. My name's Isaac, and next to me here is Melvin K. First time he's not in the top cut, participating as a player for a very long time actually. So glad to have you on stream today, and look forward to whatever we have to offer. Okay. So right now, today is one of our smaller premier challenges. We have a turnout of only about 17 or so players. And as a result, we only have a top four top cut. So not a lot of matches today, but from the looks of things so far, it's set to be just as exciting as about any of our previous PCs. Top four teams all look solid. With a few tricks up their own sleeves, so it should be really interesting to see how things play out. Anyway, on the top on the table right now here, we have first place finisher from Swiss, Nelson Lim. He went undefeated, and of course, it's not the first time we're seeing Nelson up here. And Nelson himself, being quite a seasoned player, we've seen him quite a lot over the past few years. He's even was even crowned champion in 2014. Hasn't produced quite as strong a showing in the past year, but perhaps this might be the time where he makes his comeback for things turn around. John, of course, another player that's been around quite a while, but we haven't really seen much from him. I believe he's quite close friends with Melvin. Maybe you want to give us a rundown on his history?
Well, I haven't talked to him very much recently, but I think he's been improving a lot at a good speed. So we'll see what happens in this match.
Well, anyway, we've got both players' teams on stream right now. See Nelson packing the infamous Showdown Standard 6. Talonflame, Salamence, Xerneas, Kang, Groudon, and Smeargle. Well, Jonathan here has mixed things up a little bit with Kyogre over Groudon, and Togekiss in place of Smeargle. Otherwise, the core of his team very, very similar, with Salamence and Kang is his Megas, Xerneas being Xerneas, doing what it's doing exactly what it's known for doing. Talonflame there as well, and a Primo to provide weather control, and the last slot dedicated to redirection. Togekiss and Smeargle in both cases.
Well, I have a feeling that Nelson will lead Xerneas and Smeargle.
Okay,
and that lead always happens.
That's true. We're about to find out as we jump in straight into the battle. It will be quite interesting to see how Togekiss and Smeargle actually face off, since Togekiss is in some way a Smeargle counter thanks to its ability to use Magic Code and provide speed control to outspeed Smeargle. Oh, but we see Nelson launching off with Salamence and Xerneas, while John brings his Kang and Xerneas. I guess it's become clear which Megas these players, both players, have chosen to run with this game.
I think Fake Out, maybe. John might choose to attack. That's not a bad option considering Salamence is in the field.
But either way, I think it's safe to say that Jonathan is a bit more offensive presence this turn with the Kang on the field, don't you agree?
Yeah. And so the typing is good also. So, yeah.
So I guess either way, Nelson's back into a bit of a corner. It's going to have to
figure something out.
Going to make some hard reads here in order to get past the fake out and stop Jonathan from getting up his geomancy early on and simply plowing through the rest of his team. Since, frankly speaking, the Showdown 6 is not particularly apt at dealing with a Xerneas that has set up, in my opinion, since Xerneas is able to break through most of the Showdown 6 when it's boosted after a geomancy, with the right partners, of course.
The fake out pressure is just too strong on the first turn. If you let Xerneas get a free turn up, most probably geomancy will be used.
Well, okay, we see Nelson going for the Mega Evolution with Salamence, indicating he's attempting to keep it in. John, of course, Mega is Kangaskhan as well. As we see here, okay, John straight for the fake out. Is it going to connect with Xerneas? That's quite a chunk. Critical hit there. Probably matter. It's probably going to matter at some point, honestly. Okay, we see Salamence firing off the double edge into the Xerneas. Going to do quite a chunk. I guess Nelson here probably went for the attack with his Xerneas, gambling on John eschewing the fake out in favor of more offensive pressure. But didn't really play on his favor. So now we see John's Xerneas getting up the Geomancy.
It's a bad time for Nelson now.
Yeah, it's quite a nasty position since both of Nelson's mons now are not going to want to take a Dazzling Gleam right now, so I guess Nelson really has to pull a switch now in order to turn things into his favor.
Otherwise, it would just be a double KO. You need to do something different.
But he doesn't really have a lot of options either. I guess he could switch in Talonflame or...
I think the first turn double edge was a big misplay. He should have gone for Tailwind.
But then of course, that's, you know, assuming that Nelson's Salamence actually does run Tailwind. As we know, some Salamences don't. Since Salamence is already a bit hard-pressed for slots at times. With Hyper Voice, Draco Meteor and Double Edge all having some viability and relevance in their own rights.
He could protect and switch in Talonflame. Yeah, that's a good play.
I guess Nelson's only out at this point is to be able to switch in Talonflame somehow and at least bring Talonflame in safely at some point in the game, set up a Tailwind, and from there proceed to just rely on brute force to break past John's defenses. Otherwise, it's hard to see him getting past this Xerneas right now.
Brave Bird is a good option.
But then you run into
the protect.
Is Brave Bird, would Brave Bird be enough to knock out Xerneas at this point?
Assuming it might be.
Life Orb should be, right? I don't think John's Xerneas has a significant defensive investment. 2-2 HP reads as being main minimum. Oh, okay, Nelson asked to protect his Xerneas. I think he's going for the sacrifice elements here in order to bring in Talonflame more safely. Yeah, looks like he's going for that. I guess he didn't think the switch would be worthwhile.
Sacking the Salamence to make sure that Talonflame comes in safe. That's not a bad drill.
Yeah, that's something we do see a lot of in this format since some of the more disposable Pokemon such as Salamence tend to lose their value quite quickly in battle.
He's done his fair share of the job, like damaging Xerneas and intimidating the Kangaskhan.
But in a way, this format is a lot about protecting your restricted mons, I guess, and sometimes sacrificing a less relevant, non-restricted mon tends to pay off in the long run. So yeah, as expected, we see Talonflame coming in, as we've discussed earlier. You could either go for the Tailwind or even just go for the Brave Bird.
I think you go for Tailwind. Yeah. Geomancy.
That would be... Oh, but he ends up going for the Brave Bird, straight into the Protect. Jonathan reading Nelson here like a bird. And Double Edge connects into Xerneas. How much is that going to do? Not enough to take it out, no. I think.
That's not a good time for him.
Depends on what Nelson's going to go for now. Did he go for the Geomancy? Yes, he did. And... Actually, that puts him in a really good position, if you ask me, since after this turn, Talonflame's still going to be able to apply pressure with the Brave Bird, and now Nelson has his own Xerneas at +2 special speed and special defense to further pressure Jonathan's own team. John's Kangaskhan is not going to want to be in that position right now.
As I said, the Intimidate earlier played a big part in this. I don't think the Sucker Punch will KO at this range.
Oh yeah, -1. Completely forgot that Kang has actually taken Intimidate, so... Yeah.
I think he needs to switch out the Kangaskhan. And then maybe zero, he might be able to KO with Sucker Punch.
But that's probably going to cost him a bit since Nelson doesn't really have any reason to not fire off perhaps a Moonblast into the Kangaskhan slot. And whatever John switches in is going to take a ton of damage. Doesn't look like he has a lot of stuff on his team that wants to take a Moonblast at +2. Since he doesn't really have a Groudon, and Talonflame doesn't, despite resisting Moonblast, is going to take a ton.
Oh, okay.
Brave Bird going to connect with Xerneas, of course, is going to take it out. Yes.
Yep.
I guess now it depends on whether John went for Sucker Punch and how much it's going to do. Is Sucker Punch going to connect with Xerneas? Yes, it is. How much is it going to do? Is it going
to
be enough?
He needs a crit.
Doesn't look like it.
Does it?
Oh, is it? Was that it?
Crit.
Yeah, he did get the crit.
Very lucky.
Barely taking out Xerneas. Pretty crucial crit there.
Yeah. If he didn't crit, wouldn't have killed. So, would have been a very bad time for John.
Yeah, but this puts back Nelson into a really bad position again since...
It's 2 versus 3.
I'm going to assume that his last Pokemon is Groudon. And John probably has Kyogre in the back, so... But a lot of good luck. I guess Nelson's really back in the corner now. There's no way he's gonna be able to stop Kyogre from setting up its weather. And as we all know, Kyogre in the rain, pretty much bar for some Precipice Blades crits, it's pretty much guaranteed to be able to take down any Groudon.
What do we see them use now?
I guess Nelson's only out at this point is to go for the tailwind. But even then, it's a bit iffy.
And then after that, hope the Brave Bird crits, maybe Kyogre from the back.
I'm expecting Kyogre. Not a lot of way outs here. I guess he could go for the. He would want to Flare Blitz something this turn, take advantage of the Sun while it still lasts. Of course, that's assuming that the Sun actually stays up. Although I don't think John has any reason to focus too much on keeping any of his two Pokemon on the field alive at this point. Maybe Sun Flame. Yeah. Like, I think Kang stayed with at this point.
I think they'll both tailwind up.
Would make
that
sense.
That would be the optimal play.
But all John has to do now is really just find ways to ensure his Kyogre enters the field safely.
And then KOs both of his.
No. Shouldn't be too difficult for him to secure the victory at this point.
We're down to forfeit.
Yeah, but we see Nelson forfeiting here, maybe not wanting to review any more information.
Maybe not wanting to review his Groudon set.
True.
Might be Trick Room.
Wanting to hide his Talonflame's moveset. Maybe he might.
Might not be optimal speed.
Either way, I think that's a very intelligent decision from his side, since he had, in my opinion, pretty much no way out. I think he recognized that himself and opted to just preserve information, which could play useful, play out well for the next couple of games for him. And, of course.
We'll see how John reacts to that.
I guess Nelson knows a bit more about John's team now. Judging by his Salamence Xerneas lead, I guess he wasn't expecting John to opt for
the Kangaskhan. Classic.
The classic Kang Xerneas lead here. Wonder why though. What exactly on Nelson's team deters Kang Xerneas from coming in? I thought Kang Xerneas would be a pretty safe bet against most of Nelson's options actually. Talonflame Xerneas?
Talonflame Smeargle.
Yes. But that'll only be the case if Jonathan's Kangaskhan wasn't max speed though. Otherwise I'm guessing Kang has no real issue breaking past Smeargle and Talon, right? Yeah.
But then it causes an issue for Xerneas, I guess.
Yeah. But what options does Nelson have against Xerneas Kang? I don't really see a lot right now. His own Xerneas Kang maybe? Or Kang Groudon?
Kang Smear. Would be good. Maybe Geomancy. The Xerneas and Smeargle?
Xerneas and Smeargle.
It's not bad. It's a good lead. It's always a good.
that's true. Always a way out with Moody on your side, if it works out. But I guess John has no real reason to switch up his leads right now, since it worked out for him well. And I guess Kang Xerneas is always a very safe lead, giving you plenty of options. Okay, we're about to go into the next game. Let's see how both players decide to react this time.
At this point, we haven't seen Groudon's set at all. And the Kyogre is true.
Especially in this kind of team, Groudon could work excellently both with physical and special, or even mixed variants, really.
John going with the same lead.
Oh, yeah, okay. And as we expected, we do actually see Kangaskhan Xerneas
the same lead.
John's Xerneas triggering Fairy Aura first. Perhaps you think that what we've been seeing the past few games weren't speed ties, but actually a clear advantage here with John's Xerneas perhaps being faster than Nelson's Xerneas. Although we're not really sure what the Kangaskhan speeds are, so whether or not both actually have inner focus, so
the Xerneas looks to be Nelson's Xerneas looks to be a bulky set, I guess.
Yeah.
With the intimidate and whatnot, trying to support and really set up the Geomancy.
Yeah, that would make a lot of sense. I guess right now what both players are most worried about here are really the inner focus mind games. Both players perhaps
gonna know fake
that,
out the Xerneas.
Yeah.
That would be the safest play.
But here then, depends on whether or not they would like to capitalize on that and perhaps Mega Evolve their Kangaskhans and fire off an attack on each other's Kangaskhans in order to hoping to rack up a bit more damage. Since that would be the play they need to gain an advantage here.
I think
because everybody knows that, the fake out and protect here is just a bit too obvious. It's not gonna win anyone any match here, so they're probably better off gambling a little bit. Okay, we do see Nelson making the gamble. Is it gonna pay off?
Quite a risky play. If you attack the Kangaskhan, it leaves space for the Xerneas to set up.
Yeah, but I guess you're assuming that the Kangaskhan is gonna protect. Oh, the Xerneas is gonna protect. Sorry. You see, we do see both Kangaskhans going for the Mega Evolution here. Both players not seemingly wanting to make the obvious safe play. fake out going into Xerneas, indicating that both players didn't go for protect with Xerneas either. Is Nelson gonna go for the same move? Looks like he fakes out. Ah, drawn Xerneas, so exchange of fake outs here, both Xerneas not protecting. This time Nelson getting the fake out crit.
John has to play a bit more safe because he has already won one game. Nelson has to play. Now, as we've seen, Nelson's Xerneas is slower than John's, so he has to play safe. He cannot allow the Xerneas to set up at all.
That's true. I guess both players just right now just need to focus on stopping each other's Xerneas from setting up and gaining an immediate huge advantage.
Yeah, but you never know when a protect might pop up.
Yeah, so a lot of mind games here, typical of this format where mirror matches are so common. With the format essentially revolving around the same few Pokemon. Well, not quite a Smeargle face-off, but still showing you one of the uglier sides of VGC16 right now. Okay, Nelson's Kangaskhan revealed to be going faster this turn, firing off a low kick into Jonathan's Kangaskhan.
Oh, it's
barely survives, probably EV'd to take it, I'm guessing. But it's gonna knock himself out with Double Edge here. Double Edge into Xerneas, is it gonna be enough? Looks like it. Yep. Goes down. Well, even though Nelson here effectively picks up the KO on Kangaskhan, if John goes for the Geomancy here, it's gonna get pretty ugly for him. Yep, he does.
It's unlucky of him to miss.
I wonder though, aren't most Kangaskhan's EV to survive the low kick or?
I think it's a low roll.
It's a dice roll. Oh, okay. Game not really wanting Nelson to win this time, I guess. Okay, we're back in the same position as last game in a way, with Nelson here being like lagging behind it by one Geomancy, but no, not totally helpless yet since Kangaskhan, as always, is Kangaskhan. Gonna be able to take out Xerneas at this range, I believe, and if John perhaps brings in. He's gonna be able to hit everything on John's team actually for quite a significant chunk, if I'm not mistaken.
Unless he has Smeargle at the back, otherwise it's a bad time again.
That's true. Smeargle right now would make quite a big difference.
If John has Togekiss at the back, yeah, I think almost game over for Nelson.
That's true. Okay, we're gonna see John revealing Talonflame. Is Nelson gonna send out his own Talonflame? Yes. Nelson here going for the obvious, his most obvious means of securing victory at this point, which is to once again set up Tailwind and secure the speed advantage and just pummel Jonathan's team with heavy offense.
Then again, John has the Tailwind option as well, so you might see him do that.
I guess, there's no real reason why John wouldn't just go for the Tailwind anyway, since he's pretty much guaranteed to get it up, I believe. So, wondering how Nelson's gonna maneuver around that.
Quick Guard is also a good option for John.
That's true.
But Brave Bird, I guess.
I don't think Xerneas is gonna be able to knock out Kang in his range, right? Oh, but okay, Brave Bird going in, that is probably going to connect with the Kangaskhan and bring it to KO range of Xerneas' attacks. What's Nelson's Talonflame gonna go for? Oh, Dazzling Gleam goes first, indicating that Nelson went for the Flare Blitz, probably into Xerneas, hoping to bypass Quick Guard. Not a very good turn for him at all, and I think that pretty much secures the game for Jonathan, actually. I don't think Flare Blitz is gonna kill him.
Depends if Jonathan has Quick Guard.
Probably does, right? No reason for Talonflame to run Quick Guard in this format.
It might be a speed tie, or John's one might be faster. If John's one is faster, then game over.
But once again, we're back in this position where Nelson has his Groudon forced out into the field. No option for retreating, and Jonathan probably running Kyogre in the back, so.
Pretty much game over for Nelson.
Yeah. Very commanding victory from Jonathan here, I guess. Playing his Xerneas better, in a way. Perhaps even playing the standard 6 better, I would say.
Nelson having more defensive sets cost him the game.
Guess Nelson didn't anticipate Jonathan bringing his safest mode here with Kang and Xerneas, and cost him game 1 and game 2, made his options in game 2 a lot more limited.
Jonathan gonna knock himself out with Brave Bird, knocking out John's Brave Bird. Hey, John's Talonflame in the process.
Yeah, so. But we're probably gonna see Kyogre coming at this point, so pretty sure that's it for Nelson here. Pacific Blades going to the Xerneas' protect. And I'm guessing we're gonna see Kyogre here sitting and
getting
off. Yep.
He could still survive the Moonblast and Precipice Blades.
Yeah, the thing is here though is that Jonathan's Kyogre is actually, if I'm not mistaken, 27 HP indicates that it's quite slow. In that case, is there any way you can pull it off? I'm guessing that's only possible if
Precipice crit.
Yeah, Precipice crit, then if Jonathan's only water move is always in cars, but I don't think we're gonna see that. Ooh, Moonblast taking Groudon out with a critical hit here, not even giving Nelson the chance to recover. And sealing off the set for Jonathan, commanding 2-0 sweep here. I have to say that Jonathan played both games really well here, securing a very confident position, turn one both cases with his rather boring lead, I would say, but worked out for him in the long run. And shows you why playing standard in this format really pays off. I mean, there's so few options in this format really, and it's quite clear which are the better ones so far at this point in the meta. So once again, a victory for the standard 6. Not something I really want to see as a player, but what to do? This is the game we're playing right now. All right, take a break for a while now, and probably gonna grab an interview with Jonathan, I believe, and shortly afterwards we'll be back with the final match between Jonathan and whoever pulls off the victory in the other table. Not quite sure yet.
Matthew.
We'll have to wait and see. Okay, we'll be back with an interview with Jonathan shortly. Until then, see you soon. Okay, hi everyone. We're back here with Jonathan next to me. He just won the last game, top four here, securing his victory over Nelson with a very, very boring Kangaskhan Zanya's lead. Though it was a very confident victory, I would say.
Thank you.
I believe this is the first time we're actually seeing you in the finals of a tournament, right?
Am I missing first time in the new format. Last year, I managed to get top card, I think, in two PCs, yeah.
Oh, you never really finished in the top two.
Yeah.
Oh, good for you then, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's been a running gag for a while about bubbling out.
Yeah, especially during the regionals. Yeah.
So, how does it feel right now?
Feels quite, I would say, quite accomplished, I guess. Because a lot of the players here, those who made it for today's PC, you know, we are all gunning for CPs. So yeah. All of them are very, very good, very strong players. So I'm quite happy that I managed to, you know, secure a victory there. Yeah,
must feel good. Okay, now I just want to talk about your team a little bit. Judging by both the members and the numbers I saw on screen, I'm inclined to believe that your team sits with very, very standard sets, I believe.
Yes. It's actually a variant of the standard 6 that you see in Showdown. Yeah.
I mean, with very standard numbers I'm used to seeing from my own team, which I use in International Challenge, which I admit was extremely lazy. Didn't even bother calculating anything, just smacked on 252s everywhere. So, I don't know, do you think that's... did you build your team out of that way, out of laziness, or do you think it... Did you find that those numbers were optimal from practice and everything?
Well, actually, the 252-252 spreads were quite optimal. Did quite well with them. But except that Xerneas, I think it's a bit too frail. So I invested a bit of defense in that. So I think it sort of paid off. Although it might not have done as much damage as previously built, yeah.
Well, yeah, of course, you know, there's a lot of talk in this game nowadays about how players should avoid running such suboptimal sets, but I mean, allegedly suboptimal sets, not investing, not coming up, spending more effort on coming up with custom EV spreads. I think it's paying off relatively well for you so far.
I think so. I think the extra defense EVs in my Xerneas sort of paid off. If not, I wouldn't have been able to survive quite a few of the attacks.
That's true. Okay. So glad to see that you're enjoying yourself here right now.
Thank you.
All the, wish you all the best in your upcoming game, and we'll see you soon in the finals.
Yeah, and happy Chinese New Year to all, to all our watchers out there. Yeah.
Happy Chinese New Year, everyone, as well. 恭喜发财.
I don't know anything, so